basically what we do is we give you a smaller amount of what you would totally qualify for, and we give that to you based on a certain amount. So what we do is we give you the first installment, and then you draw on that as you need it. So as long as you're not at your maximum funding amount, we can continue to fund you, and the payments will roll off as you pay back those amounts.
Okay, that makes sense. And also, one of the things that you guys do that some others in your space don't do is offer very, very, very discounted prepayment incentives.
So we like to offer our clients the ability to pay us back at the cheapest rate possible for the amount of money we're giving them. Now, by giving them these early terms, we can save them anywhere from 5 to 15% off their advance.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. So let's talk about profitability as it relates to lines of credit. So the only program that you would need to show financials for with a line of credit would be a 12-month because it carries monthly. For a 12-month line of credit, our customers typically need to have 680 credit or better, 3 years in business, and they have to be doing about $400,000 in revenue over the course of a year. Now, if they check all those boxes, you need to show financials and you need to be able to show a profit on those financials. When it comes to SBA loans and profitability, they're really looking for 2 years of strong profits, growing profits, and growing revenues. So if you have a down year, it could affect if you can actually take an SBA or not. When they underwrite SBAs, they will look to see what's being written down. So if you're writing everything down to zero, and that's just the normal for your business, but you can see that the owner of the business has taken a salary, that's something that, you know, could be overlooked in the process and may actually get approved, as opposed to, oh, you're not making profit, you know, in 2015 or 2016, it's an automatic decline. When it comes to MCAs, the only time financials come into play is on larger, you know, rounds of financing.
Typically what we see, John, is with the larger deals, the financials tend to be more accurate, so therefore they play a bigger role. You know, on smaller businesses, most of these merchants are working with
QuickBooks
or something like that. So if they make one wrong journal entry, we tend to look at that a little bit more softly.
Okay. So what I would say is, you know, if you're looking for, let's just say, $75,000 or higher, financials would come into play with a company like Libertas. There are other companies and underwriters that we have that, you know, financials don't come into play until someone's borrowing $150,000 or more. So really, it's about knowing your business. Anytime you're going to apply for financing, any tips and tricks that I could give you would be, you know your business inside and out, have your statements ready and available, and also know exactly how much money you need and what you're going to be doing with the money, because a lot of times when I discuss, you know, applications or my clients with Joe or some of my other underwriters, they really want to know what the money is going towards. And if I can show them that by borrowing $10,000, $15,000, $100,000, you're going to invest in equipment or inventory or something that's really going to have an impact on your business, it's much easier to get that approved.
John, one of the things we say about Libertas is we are very much a story shop. You know, we always want to hear what the merchant has to say, even if it's something that doesn't fit our traditional box. The biggest thing we want to do is work to help your business grow. Now, if we can do that by giving you $10,000 to help put an extra lift in your auto repair shop, or $15,000 to buy a second pizza oven so that you can, you know, make more pizzas, that's something we want to do.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. If anybody has any questions about this, feel free to email me or message me on Facebook. Joe, I appreciate your time and you coming in and explaining some of the things that, you know, clients are looking at. It helps when you hear it from an underwriter and not just, you know, the